Hi guys, I'm Jessica Welman with Play USA, and we're going to continue talking Oscars, except this time we're going to talk about the most wide open of the acting categories, Best Supporting Actress. Now, you can check the odds daily on Best Supporting Actress on our Oscar betting page, which is a great resource for all sorts of things like where you can bet, what the odds are at different sports books, and, as you see here, some pretty cool deposit bonuses and other offers we have going, like $500 in a free bet at BetStars or DraftKings, $500 at FanDuel. You want to check the terms and conditions, of course, but there are plenty of cool options to use when it comes to Oscars betting. Now, Best Supporting Actress. It's the only one of these that is pretty much not a foregone conclusion, but the favorite is still pretty accurate. Not many people saw Barry Jenkins, who directed Moonlight's follow-up, If Beale Street Could Talk, but this much-lauded movie does have one award that it should be getting, which is Regina King's performance in it as Best Supporting Actress. So, taking a look at FanDuel, you'll see she is the minus 210 favorite, which is not as steep as you're going to see on some of these other big categories, whereas her competition, there are some long shots and some people that are closer to beating her than other categories with other favorites. All right, so Regina King, what does she have going for her? Mostly, it's her track record. If you look at when this woman is nominated for awards, she wins about 75% of the time. She's been nominated for 4 Emmys. She has won 3. She has won Golden Globes. She has won SAG Awards. She wins everything because everybody loves her. I want to tell you that the Academy is all about the pristine performances and nothing to do about whether or not the people behind them are nice people, but it kind of matters. And Regina King is considered a very nice, likable person in a campaign where you do kind of have to suck up and do the publicity round. So she has that going for her. She's a really great actress and people really like her. But there are some possibilities here, so let's run down the other contenders. The one considered the closest bet to beating Regina King is Amy Adams for her performance as Lynn Cheney in Vice. This is Amy Adams' 6th Oscar nomination without a win, which is a lot, but I think because Amy Adams is only 44 years old and she basically gets nominated for something every year, Academy voters are probably going to be a little choosier than they would if she was an older actress like a Glenn Close, who we'll talk about in the Best Actress video. This is just an impersonation of Lynn Cheney when you get down to it. She doesn't really have a ton to do other than play the motivated yet supportive wife, and we've seen how much better she can be in other roles like last year's Arrival, that it's just not her time. Now, the next two kind of go hand in hand, which is Rachel Weisz and Emma Stone. They're both in the movie The Favorite, and let's be honest, neither of them are really supporting actresses. All three of the women in this movie are all basically leads, but Emma Stone is considered, of the three women in this movie, the one with the least interesting performance. Not that it was bad, but just compared to the other two, it's not really up to snuff. So that is why FanDuel has her listed at plus 1800, BetStars has her listed at plus 1600, and Caesars has her listed at plus 2000. The interesting bet here is Rachel Weisz. So she already has the Best Supporting Actress Oscar. She won a few years ago for a movie very few of you probably saw called The Constant Gardener. She gets nominated for things a lot, a la Amy Adams, but she's the only one besides Regina King with momentum in her favor. This is where things get really weird. So at the SAG Awards, Regina King was not nominated and Amy Adams and Rachel Weisz were. However, the actors voted for Emily Blunt for her performance in A Quiet Place. Emily Blunt's not nominated for an Oscar. Then we get to the British Oscars that took place last weekend, and Rachel Weisz won, which is good for her, but she's also British, that if she hadn't won, it would have been really surprising, especially because Regina King wasn't nominated there either. So Regina King's weakness is mostly that she hasn't gotten some of these important nominees in her corner, but I still stand by, people love this woman. If there is someone who is the favorite to upset, it would be Rachel Weisz for The Favorite. And we've got to spend a minute talking about someone that I know you're going to respond with who, which is Marina de Tavira. She is the mother of the family in Roma, and this Best Supporting Actress nomination kind of came out of nowhere. She hasn't been nominated for anything. It's possible to get nominated for nothing and storm on to a win late in Oscar season. Marsha Gay Harden did so in Pollock about 10 years ago. But I think that what we can take from this nomination is more a testament to Roma than it is to this woman's performance. Actors are the biggest branch of the Academy, so if they're willing to put her up for supporting actress, their support behind Roma as best film might be stronger than you realize. All right, so let's take one look at Rachel Weisz's odds before we call it a day. You see that at FanDuel, she's plus 1,100, which is not bad. Meanwhile, though, at BetStars, she's at 4-1, which is just plus 400. Not a very good amount for your buck in terms of bang. And then over at Caesars, she is plus 700. In other words, FanDuel's where you want to go if you want to make sure that you get the most money for predicting the upset if Rachel Weisz does come out on top. Now, if you're wondering again how to deposit and make the most of your money, be sure to click the links in the description and we can lead you to our best deposit offers.